Well, good Monday morning from NASA's Johnson Space Center. This is Mission Control Houston. It's October 22nd, 2012. A team of flight controllers here in the station, Mission Control Center, are overseeing activities aboard the International Space Station throughout the day. The flight control team today is led by Flight Director Judd Freeling. He's joined on console by Capcom, who is serving as the spacecraft communicator, or the person who is in charge of activities linking the voice in terms of the voice between this team and the crew on board the International Space Station. That crew enjoying its 100th day in space today, led by Commander Sunny Williams. She's on her second or her third flight into space, actually second. She served on the Expedition 14 and 15 crews, so she's very well versed in long duration stays in space. She's joined in the center. You see Yuri Malenchenko, the most flown crew member of the three that represent the Expedition 33 crew, Russian cosmonaut. He's flown on the shuttle. He's flown to the Russian Mir space station and also served on a couple of expedition crews to the International Space Station. Also part of the Expedition 33 crew is Aki Hoshide, representing the Japanese Aerospace Exploration Agency. He's on his second flight. He flew a shuttle mission STS-124 before taking part in this long-duration flight to the International Space Station. These three crew members arrived at the station back in mid-July, and they are scheduled to return home late at night U.S. time on November 18th. The crew is busily preparing for the arrival of three new crew members to join them aboard the International Space Station as part of the Expedition 33 crew for a while until that November departure. The three newest crew members are at the Baikonur Cosmodrome in Kazakhstan, preparing for their launch scheduled for Tuesday morning. The crew members will support Expedition 33 and Expedition 34. They'll launch on Tuesday aboard their Soyuz TMA-06M spacecraft. U.S. astronaut Kevin Ford, one of the three crew members, along with two rookie cosmonauts, Oleg Novitsky and Yevgeny Tarelkin. Those three are preparing for actually, they're asleep right now, and they'll be waking up this early this evening for their launch preparations. And all of that, of course, will be carried live here on NASA television. So the crew on board the International Space Station is preparing for their arrival. They're also preparing for a number of other activities ongoing aboard the International Space Station, including experiment work. They spent a fairly quiet weekend checking on some experiments, talking with family members, and also reviewing some procedures for upcoming activities aboard the station, one of which is a spacewalk that is currently being targeted for November 1st to repair an ammonia leak on one of the station's left side or port side radiators. So today they're also reviewing those procedures as well and talking with the ground where necessary throughout the day. So the crew's in a busy day, a busy week with visiting vehicles coming and going. The Dragon SpaceX spacecraft is set to depart this coming Sunday, and so a lot of activity with stowage in the Dragon is scheduled throughout the week ahead of its departure and return home, and also the arrival next week on October 31st of the next supply vehicle, the Russian Progress 49 cargo ship that's scheduled to launch on the 31st, arriving at the station about four orbits later on the same day. So a busy traffic pattern activity aboard the International Space Station as the crew in and around that performs a number of experiment work and exercises to keep their systems in great shape to support their long-duration stay in space.